MaxTrack Live looks great because there is not a single raindrop on it. We're in good shape for today. Continuing the trend that started Sunday afternoon, of course, we had all that wind yesterday, Sunday, and then yesterday it was as chilly. Today, we're kind of hitting the sweet spot. Some hazy sunshine, the wind has backed off, we continue to warm up, and there isn't much anywhere near us. You got to go either north or south. Snow up north and rain way down south, and of course, Kentucky caught in between. They've had blizzard conditions up in Maine, so some folks are still getting hammered with big time winter. And it's a pretty soggy go of it down toward the Gulf Coast. We still have ongoing flood warnings, and it's the exact same spots they've been the last couple of days. Wayne County down through Whitley, Knox counties, and also off to the east, northeast, Leslie County up towards West Liberty, northwestern Morgan County and northwest due to ongoing flooding. So watch out for that. But the floodwater should continue to recede next couple of days. And there is some good news, even though we do have rain on the way, it's not looking like it's going to be particularly heavy, and it should be spread out quite a bit. Now, there's a minimal chance for maybe, just maybe, an isolated sprinkle, a shower or two tomorrow. You can see the clouds thickening up in just a hint by Wednesday evening. Isolated showers and sprinkles tracking east, and those will be out of here. It's a minimal chance, but unfortunately, the rest of the week, that rain chance does go up. And we need to talk about the wettest February. We are at our sixth wettest, 7.32 inches of rain. But look at London. In the month of February, and remember, it's a short month, and we're not done with it yet. You guys have had over 11 inches of rain, so no wonder. You and Jackson at, well, over 8.5 inches there, approaching 8 3/4, are at your wettest ever. So, yeah, we're pretty soggy. And we will add to this, but this is Thursday through Sunday. And, of course, we're kicking over to March as well as this time lapse goes on. But we're only showing quarter to maybe a half an inch of rain. So the heaviest rain is going to stay confined down toward the Gulf Coast. So we can breathe a little easier, even though there is an increasing chance for rain later this week. I don't think it's going to be anywhere near what we've been dealing with lately. So good news. 51 now, hazy sunshine. We're already above our average high. We've got a northeasterly wind that will eventually become more easterly. And we should make it, that's the current, upper 40s to low 50s, into the mid 50s for highs today. Even some southern counties trying to take a crack at 60. We're all going to take a crack at 60 tomorrow. And then some. We could hit around 60 for the high Wednesday and even see some low to mid 60s into our southern counties before temperatures start to nosedive later this week. Mid 50s, mostly sunny today, hazy sunshine, so get out and enjoy it. Mid 30s tonight, we may not even get down to freezing, but we'll be close. And then tomorrow, a high of around 60. Again, that late day minimal chance for maybe a stray shower or a sprinkle. And here you go. Boy, your 8-day doesn't look all that good, does it? Once you get past Thursday, temperatures going down, the rain chance pretty steady. Again, it'll be daily and it'll be light. Overnight lows cold enough. We may at times have a bit of a wintry mix with those lows in the 30s. And yes, there is a cold snap brewing. I'm hoping, in addition to it getting colder, though, we will also dry out a little bit. So there are some signs out there that we could have a run of dry days to go along with that cold snap. So, you know, some good with the bad.
All right, Tom, thank you.